Hello ladies and gents, how are you guys doing? In today's video, I'll be sharing with you one of a few tricks that I use for any cinematic color grading effect that I want to use on my smartphone. So your picture will literally change from this that you're seeing into something like this. Cool, right? So without further philandering, let's get right into the video. So this is the image we'll be working with. It was taken on a Redmi Note 5A Prime. It is around 25 MB because this is the RAW format and I'll be editing it using Lightroom Mobile. So let's get started. So the first thing I want to do here is reduce the exposure because this was taken in direct sunlight and this light is just too much. So to do that, you want to go to light here and you want to reduce the exposure. Meanwhile, the values I'll be using in this video might not be the direct value you'll be using because I just want to show you the basic of getting the cinematic color grading. So our pictures differ, the values differs. So the exposure, I would like to bring it down something like this. The contrast, let's say 11 is good, 10, 11. Then the highlights, you want to bring it down a little bit. Shadows, I want to increase it. I don't want everything to just be. Okay. Yeah, so this is good. Now for the white, I won't be using too much white because I want the cloud to show. Instead, I'll just go for the black. Then I'll reduce the black to something like 13. Yes, this is good for me. Now moving on, let's go into our temperature. So that is that for the lightning and the darkness. So that is that for the lightning and stuffs. Let's go into the color grading. So for the temperature, let's just reduce it a little bit. Okay, I won't use the tint because I don't want to use it. Then this vibrant, just I'll be using a little bit. Saturation, I won't need that. Let's go into our mix. So this is where we are going to grade all our colors. It is very simple, just try and get the basic. For this image, we are not having much of red, but we are having green. So to edit this green, what you want to do is, let's say I pick green here and I increase it, it is going to turn greenish. And if I reduce it, it is going to turn yellowish. At least you can see the colors of the leaves and the trees. Then this saturation is just going to increase the color. This will turn it to something black and white. So I hope you understand that. So I'll put it back. So whatever you want to do, just make sure the values are not too high and not too low. You just want to do it slightly. And make sure you watch out for your picture when you are editing this because every values count. So for the red, I'll be using something like 10, 9 because you might not see it, but there is a red house here that I can see. And the saturation, I'll just leave it as it is. Let's go to the orange. For the orange, which is kind of the color of the street, like color of the road, so I'll just increase that, put that to it. Then the saturation, I'll increase it to like 50-51. That's okay for me. Then this yellow, I'll reduce it. Okay, something 50. Let's see. Okay, something like this. Then this green, which is the grass and the tree. Let's say 7. Okay. I would not use 100. 50 is okay. 55. Then the saturation, something like this is okay for me. Notice that there is a greenhouse in this picture. As I'm increasing, the color of the greenhouse is also changing. So that is what color grading basically do. It picks the color you want, then it increases or it reduces the color of such material or object, or you get what I'm trying to say. Sorry. So Let's move on. This blue, I can see blue here. The color of the pigment is somehow bluish. Okay, so I'll do like this. Okay, I can see another blue and it's changing. So I would leave it like this. Okay, now this is the main blue. I'll reduce this. As I'm reducing this blue, notice that the color of the sky is also changing. That if I increase this, it's going to change the color of the cloud to is looking as if it's about to rain. But I'll reduce it, yes, something like this. I think I like this one better. For the purple, I don't think there is any purple here. This one too, I don't think so. So the next thing I want to do, is increase the texture, because this is a picture of a street. I have to make it look more realistic, you know. So I'll increase the texture, something like 20 is okay. Then I'll boost the clarity. Then I'll de-aze this to reduce the lightning also. Then the vignette, or whatsoever pronunciation it is, I'll reduce it. It is actually going to create a black corners around the picture, so something like this. Let me, okay, as you can see, this is what the vignette does, but I won't be using it too much. Let's say 18 is good. So midpoint, all the sun, I won't be using them. Okay, let's go to sharpness, because I would want to increase the sharpness to something like 45. Okay, then the radius, let's say 1.20 or 1.10. yeah, then the details, I'll put it to 40, so it can be more, I don't know. So for masking, I will increase that too. The masking will just help you to reduce the sharpness on the edges. So I'll choose like 40, noise reduction, blah blah blah. Don't want this. The color noise reduction, put it to 0. Yes, we're pretty done. So now what we want to do now is we want to apply a preset. Now the main reason why I did not apply a preset at first is so you can see the color for what they are truly, and you can edit them individually. That is the reason why I did not use the preset at first. So to use the preset, you want to go back here to the profile here, and I want to go to artistic. So I'll be going for artistic 4, but you might choose anyone you want to use if it is working perfectly with your picture. So I'll be using artistic 4 because it looks more cinematic to me. But I'll be reducing this value here because it looks too harsh to the eyes. So let's just put it around 70. Yep. And now as you can see, we are already having a cinematic look. So that is just the basic of how you can get this effect using Lightroom. So this is our before. Can you just imagine? And this is our after. Now this can be used for any picture whatsoever. And I'll be making more videos about this cinematic color grading until you become a boss yourself. So let me know in the comments box if you like this video. If you enjoy what I do, please do well to subscribe. I'll be waiting for you guys in the comments box. I would so love to see the beautiful things you guys have created. And if you have any question for me, or if you want to talk to me about anything, so I'll put my direct WhatsApp line in the description box. If you want to talk to me, you know, I don't mind making some friends. So yes, thank you for watching, and till next time I come your way, peace out.